Hello everyone, I'd like to welcome you all to this quick introduction on observability with Amazon OpenSearch service. My name is Muthu Pichamani. I'm a specialist solution architect focusing exclusively on Amazon OpenSearch serving, helping customers to build solutions with OpenSearch. The chances are high that you heard about observability a lot in the last few years. So let's look at what observability actually is. Observability, roughly defined, is a measure of how well you can infer the internal state of a system by just looking at its external outputs. Why do we need it? Because over the years, the complexity of the system is growing and it becomes quite impossible to go look into each component of the system and understand the behavior. So it becomes very imperative to know, to characterize the behavior of a complex system by just looking at its outputs. So that's where observability comes in very handy. So where does observability itself fit in? To understand this, I'm going to step back a little and talk to you about what is called as operational analytics. Operational analytics is not something new. It is a field that spawned out of another field called operation research, which has been going on for 3 or 4 decades in industrial and manufacturing. So operational analytics is a field, the aim of which to improve your business efficiency and or customer experience or value. That's what it is. Traditionally, when you run a business, operation research, they did a large batch processing system and then crunch the numbers and then produce a report that helps you to make a business decision through a manual process. Operation analytics aims to replace the manual process with a machine-enabled or machine processing methods so that you can arrive at this business insight quickly. And there are different components of operational analytics. The first and foremost is what is called as descriptive analytics. This is where you describe a complex system to say what it is, then try to characterize its behavior. The next one is called as predictive analytics. This refers to all the business operations and the things that you do that after characterizing the system, you can predict how the system is going to behave in future. Then lastly, what is called as prescriptive analytics. Once you know what the system is, and once you know how you can predict it, prescriptive analysis tend to prescribe a solution to the problem that it's having. This is where many exciting things like machine learning based and artificial intelligence based system can be used, and so that whatever that has been involving manual systems can be kind of automated in a fashion so the machine becomes really intelligent. So where does observability fit in? Observability fits in this descriptive analytics where it tends to describe what a complex system is. Okay, so what is the goal of observability? Just like operational analytics, the goal of your observability is to improve the overall end user experience that you provide with your applications and your services. And if you ask an operational center person, what is the aim of observability? They'll tell you that the aim of observability is to reduce what is called this mean time to knowledge. So if an issue, mean time to knowledge, what it means is that you need to be able to understand that something is going on within a system first. Then you need to understand what is going on in the system so that you can formulate a solution to it. So this is measured in terms of what is called this mean time to knowledge and mean time to resolution. So the one aim of observability is to reduce these mean time to knowledge and resolution so that you can improve the overall user experience of a system itself. So what are the pillars of observability? Observability as a means for a system to become observable, you need different kinds of data that you need to collect from it. The first and the foremost is the logs. Logs are immutable events that occur over time that helps you to get an insight on what is going on within a system. So they emanate from different parts like your applications, your services, your infrastructure, and so on. Next is a metric data. Metric data is a numerical measurement of a state of a system that helps you to understand the resource usage and things like that. So over time, you can understand the trends and that helps you to predict what is going on within the system later on. The last and the final type of data is what are called traces. Traces are data that provides you the visibility into the end-to-end flow of your user request as it from the time it enters the system and till the time it is serviced. So these three are the important data that allows you to gain insight into your complex system. So now I'll give you a very quick introduction into what are the components that are there in Amazon OpenSearch service that helps you to collect these observability data and to gain an insight from them. The first and foremost is what we call as an observability UI. This is a UI that is that has different things like event analytics, trace analytics. Event analytics is a UI that allows you to interactively look at your logs, metrics, and also your trace information. Logs and your trace information using what is called as a piped processing language. The next is a trace analytics. It's a UI that helps you to visually inspect and interact with these traces that you collected from the different parts of your system and help to zero in on the issue very quickly. We also already saw what pipe processing language. It's a language that you can use, if you're familiar with the Linux terminology, that you can use to interactively query your data by piping them through different, just by using pipes. So you take a data, pipe it into another system, then it processes it and you can interactively build the visualizations from it. Next is what is called this OpenTelemetry. It's an open source project that aims to standardize the collection, the store and visualization of all this data and the associated libraries, SDKs and protocol itself. And the data prepper is a component that consumes the data from OpenTelemetry and then prepares it in a fashion that is that can be consumed into Amazon OpenSearch service. Here is an architecture that shows you how you can collect these data with the different components, store them, and then visualize them. For storing, you have a couple of options with Amazon OpenSearch service and Amazon Managed Service of Prometheus. And for visualization, again, you have a couple of options with the Amazon OpenSearch service and using Amazon Managed Grafana. I hope this has been useful in getting introduced to what is observability and what are all different components in Amazon OpenSearch service. As a next step, you have this lab that you can go and play around with to understand and build the components for yourself. Thank you so much.